Now the first step is to restart a computer. Simply restart a computer once, and after the system restart, launch the game. Do not ignore this step. Restart a computer once and then check. Still not working, try DX11 or DX12 in the launch option. Make a right click on the game, go to properties, and over here you can type in -DX11. Now you can launch the game and then check. If that does not work, make a right click, go to properties, and this time you can type in -DX12 over here. And then you can, once you type in -DX12, launch the game and then check. Still not working, remove this and then follow the next step. Now the next step is to rename or delete the config folder. When you rename or delete the config folder, all the saved settings will be lost. Now for this, you can go to File Explorer, go to this PC, open C drive, now open Users folder. Now open your username folder, now open App Data. If you don't see App Data at the top, click on View, select Show, put a check on Hidden Items. Open App Data folder, open the local folder, open SHF folder, save folder. Here you can see config, create a backup if you want. You can copy this, you can paste it to the desktop. Once you have a backup created, now you can make a right click and then you can rename this folder. And now you can launch the game and then check. If that does not work, you can even rename the complete SHF folder. Now before this, create a backup first, because you will lose all the save game progress. You have to start everything from scratch. So create a backup first. So you will lose all the save game progress will be lost when you do so. So we have already created a backup. So once you create a backup, now you can rename this folder .old. Now you can launch the game, and once you are able to launch the game, if you want, you can just paste the save game folder back to the location and then check. Next step is to perform clean installation of your graphics card driver. So if you have Nvidia card, go to Nvidia website. If you have AMD card, go to AMD website. I'm showing for Nvidia. So go to Nvidia website, select your graphic card from the list. Make sure that you select your graphic card, your operating system over here, and then click on Find. Now on this page, you will see the latest graphic card driver. Whichever is the latest graphic card driver, GeForce Game Ready driver. Right now it's 581.29. Click on View and then click on Download over here. Once the download is complete, you can run this exe file. When you run this exe file, click on Yes to allow, click on OK, click on Agree and Continue. Select Custom option over here and then click on Next. Put a check on the box which says Perform a clean installation and then click on Next. And once the clean installation is done, restart the computer and then check. This has worked for many players, so it might work for you. Now the next step is to laptop users with dual graphic card run the game on dedicated graphic card. Now for this, type in graphics settings in Windows search box and then click on graphics settings over here. And then click on Add desktop app, go to the game installation folder. So wherever the game is installed, in my case the game is installed in C drive. This is the location in my case. Select the game exe file over here and then click on Add. Once the game is added over here, find the game in the list. Now once you find the game, click on the game and over here select High Performance and you will see your graphic card. Again click on Add desktop app and then this time open this SHF folder, binaries win64. Select this exe file and then click on Add. Again scroll down and find the game in the list. Once you find the game, click on the game and again select High Performance and you will see your graphic card over here. Now launch the game. Now the next step is to run the game from the game installation folder. Now for this, you can make a right click on the game, select Manage, click on Browse Local Files. This will take you to the game installation folder. Now open this SHF folder, binaries win64, and select this exe file. Make a double click, launch the game from here. If that does not work, make a right click, go to properties, go to this tab, put a check on the box which says run this program as an administrator, hit apply, click on OK, make a double click, launch the game and then check. If that does not work, again go to properties. This time you can try Windows 8, hit apply, click on OK, launch the game. You can even try Windows 7 over here, hit apply, click on OK. Try disable full screen optimization, hit apply, click on OK, launch the game and then check. Now when you put a check on all these boxes still not working, in that case you can uncheck these boxes, hit apply, click on OK, and then you can try to run this exe file as well as an administrator and then check. Still not working. The next step is to allow the game exe file to your antivirus program. So first of all, I'm using Windows Security, so you can go to Windows Security, Privacy and Security, Windows Security, and then click on Virus and Threat Protection. Scroll down at the bottom, you will see Manage Ransomware Protection. Click on it. Click on Allow an App to Control Folder Access. Click on Yes to Allow. Add an Allowed App, Browse All Apps. Now go to the Game Installation folder and then open the Game folder. Select the Game EXE file over here. Click on Open. Add all the EXE file. This folder binaries win64. Add this and check if there are any more exe file. That's it. So add it now. Type in control panel in Windows search box and then go to System and Security, Windows Defender Firewall. Click on Allow an App or Feature through Windows Defender Firewall. Click on Change Settings, Allow another App. Click on Browse. And then again go to the game installation folder, open the game folder, select all the exe file. In my case it is already added. Again click on allow another app, click on browse, and then select it, add. Again allow another app, browse, open this SHF folder, binaries win64, select this one, add. And then once the game is added over here, now you can launch the game and then check. Still not working. The next step is to verify the game file. This is important. Make a right click on the game, select properties, go to install files tab, and then click on verify integrity of game files. Once the verification is 100% complete, launch the game and then check. Still not working. The next step is to install Visual C++ file. Now for this, you can go to Microsoft website. So in Google search, you can type in install Visual C++ file and go to the official website. And here you can see Visual Studio files. Download this x86 and x64. Download this x86 and then download this, run this exe file. If you see the repair option, click on repair. If you see the install button, hit install. Click on yes to allow. Download this x64 file as well and then run this exe file. Again, if you see the repair option, click on repair. If you see the install button, hit install. And once the installation is complete, now restart game builder. And after the system restart, launch the game. Still not working. The next step is to, you can skip this step if you're not able to launch the game. But if you're able to launch the game, try window mode, lower down resolution, lower down video settings, and lock the FPS at 60, and then you can check. So if you're able to launch the game, launch the game. Now, once you launch the game, you can go to options, go to graphics. You can try window mode over here. So if this is set to full screen, you can switch to window mode. And then you can lower down resolution. If this is set to 4K, try 1920 into 1080p. You can even lower down more. Set the FPS at 60. And then for preset, if this is set to like, you can try balanced. For me, balance is working fine. You can try balance or performance quality. You can check one by one and check which one is working fine for you. And then scroll down. Here you can see indirect lighting. Now, if this is set to lumen high, like epic, then you can set it to high. You can even turn it off and then you can check the performance. Now, next step is to increase the virtual memory. Now, for this, you can type in View Advanced System Settings in Windows search box and then click on View Advanced System Settings. Now, under Advanced, click on First Setting and then go to Advanced tab and then click on Change. Uncheck this box. Select the drive where the game is installed. You have to select that drive and then you have to select custom size. Now we will make these changes. If this does not work, we can always revert back to the default. So select custom size and for initial size 1.5 multiplied total RAM. Now you can check total RAM on your computer. You can go to system and then you can go to about, and for me it's 16 gigabytes. So you have to calculate as per your gigabyte. In my case it's 16. So 16 gigabyte multiplied 1024, that is in megabyte in total, multiplied 1.5 for initial size, that is 24576. And then for maximum size, 3 multiplied total RAM, in my case 16 gigabyte is the total, multiplied 1024 in megabyte, multiplied 3, that is 49152 in my case. And then you have to click on set. Set is important. Click on set and then click on OK. OK. And then you can launch the game and then check. You can even restart your computer once and then check. Again, type in View Advanced System Settings. If that does not work, go to Advanced, click on First Settings, Advanced, Change. This time select System Manage Size and then click on Set. Set is important. Then click on OK. Click on OK, Apply, OK. Okay, you will see a restart option, restarting computer, and then you can check. Still not working, we will revert back to default. So you can go to View Advanced System Settings once again, Settings, Advanced, Change. You can put a check over here and this will go to default. And then follow the next step. Now, the next step is to try power saver mode. Now for this, type in Control Panel in Windows search box and then go to Control Panel. Go to Hardware and Sound and then go to Power Options. In my case, I have only Balanced. In your case, if you find this Power Saver, you can select Power Saver and then you can launch the game. You can even go for Balanced and High Performance. Check which one is working fine for you. But first of all, try Power Saver. Now, if you're using this Intel Extreme Tuning Utility, you can lower down performance score ratio to maybe 55, 54 or 53x and then make sure that you hit Apply at the bottom and then relaunch the game and then check. Still not working. The next step is to turn on or turn off hardware accelerated GPU scheduling. Now for this, type in graphics settings in Windows search box, click on graphics settings and go to advanced graphics. And if hardware accelerated GPU scheduling, if this is off, turn it on and then relaunch the game and then check. Now if this is already on, you can turn it off and then check. Now the next step is to try launching the game from NVIDIA app. So you can launch NVIDIA app and then you can go to graphics and then over here, go to home and you will see the game over here. Try to launch, click on play, try to launch the game from here and then check. Also, you can go to settings. If you see optimize option over here, you might see optimize like this. If you see optimize, you can hit optimize. In my case, I don't have it. But if you see optimize, optimize it and then launch the game. And if it is already optimized, you will see revert option. You can revert and then once you revert it, you can close NVIDIA app. Do not use NVIDIA app in that case and then launch the game. Next step is to update Windows to the latest version. This is important. So go to Windows update or update and security and then click on check for update. Once all the updates are installed over here, then restart it mirror. And after the system restart, launch the game. Next step is to update the BIOS. So go to your system manufacturer website, select your model number and then update the BIOS. In case of laptop, make sure battery is more than 10% and the AC adapter is connected to the computer when you update the BIOS update, when you perform the BIOS update. And once the BIOS update is done, log into the computer and then launch the game. Next step is to unplug all the external devices which you're not using. So if you have rotors, wheel, pedals, any kind of USB adapter connected to the computer, connected, disconnected. If you have external keyboard connected, disconnected, disconnect extra controller. Sometimes we have dongle, extra controller connected, disconnected. Disable or enable the Steam overlay. Now for this, you can go to Steam, make a right click on the game, go to properties, and then turn off the option which says enable the Steam overlay while in game. If this is already off, you can turn it on and then check. So try both and then check. If you have any other overlay application like Discord running, go to Discord settings, turn off overlay and then close Discord. NVIDIA app, you can go to NVIDIA app settings and then you can go to settings and then you can turn off this NVIDIA overlay and then you can launch the game or you can and then you can close the NVIDIA app. Do not overclock. If you have overclocked, set it to default. Close all the overclocking application like MSI Afterburner, Reverb Tuner, any kind of overclocking application running, close it. Close OBS. If you have any third-party services running or application running, close all the third-party application and services and then check. If you have undervolted your computer, remove the undervolt and then launch the game. The last step is to uninstall and reinstall the game to different drives. So if nothing is working, make a right click on the game, manage, uninstall. After the uninstall, go to the game installation folder, delete the game folder, restart the computer, and then install the game to C drive. So if the game is installed to D drive or E drive, try to install the game to C drive and then check. If the game is already installed to C drive, try installing the game to another SSD and then check. So one of the steps shown in this video should help you to run this game successfully on a Windows computer. So that'll be all. Thank you so much for your time and please like this video and subscribe to my channel.